For the namesake of starting the classes today, okay? So today let us just try to complete the unit conversions, okay, that you need to remember for the gate examination, okay? Okay, see guys, today what we'll be doing is we will be just be completing the unit conversions. Okay, so after completing the unit conversions, we will have small exercises and then we will stop the class today. Okay, it will take just half an hour. Okay. So guys, before starting the classes, those students who have arrived for the demo classes, let me just explain what we will be doing through this whole particular course. Okay, see, from today onwards the particular classes will start. Daily we will have 2 to 3 hour classes. Okay, every week we will have 2 tests. That is, after the particular test we will have a live class paper discussion. Guys, this particular live class paper discussion is very very important, because during this particular session only you will able to clear all your doubts and enhance your understanding of that particular concept. Okay, see, the main reason for having every week 2 tests is we can focus on a particular topic. Suppose for the first week, the first exam will be on unit conversions only. Okay, this is very 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 basic, the unit conversions, but it is very very useful throughout the entire course. Okay, you need to be able to convert the units in either well testing, reservoir engineering, drilling engineering, any other thing, just by remembering the 6 formulas that I will be giving you. You need to able to solve any type of conversions through the whole petroleum engineering syllabus. Okay, the first exam will be on unit conversions. Okay, specifically on unit conversions. From tomorrow onwards we will start porosity, that is the petrophysical properties of rock. So the second exam will be on porosity 1. What we will be doing is we will be specifically targeting a particular topic. Suppose porosity, permeability will be on, we'll have a separate exam, saturation separate exam, capillary pressure separate exam, wettability separate exam, so that we can attack the basic concepts and understand it more clearly. And each particular test will be somewhat very hard. Okay, so apart from these particular tests, what we'll be doing is we will be, because this is a 11 months course, we'll be having a very large amount of time between now and the gate examination. So we will be completing every exercises in different books, starting with Abhijit Dandekar book, Kraft and Hawkins, Tarak Ahmad. Similarly, there are 5 to 6 books which specifically has exercises after every chapter. We will complete those and we will discuss it in the class. Okay, apart from that, these every class will be recorded and it will be available to you in both laptop and mobile phone, that you can view until gate examination. And the last one is the free video lecture series. These video lecture series will not be useful to you right now, because once 6 or 7 months has been completed, if you want to go and see a particular topic, you can use this video lecture series. And 12 books, I think you already know that. 10 are of our publications, that is the DICE publications. two are of different publications, that is Aptitude and Mathematics are of GTA publications. These are of GK publications, and yeah, apart from this, there are several other things. I think you can view it in the in our website, guys. By using this course, we will be completing the whole syllabus by November end. Okay, from December first week onwards, we will be starting a new course where we will have an examination every day. With live class prep. Okay, and that's it regarding this online live classes course. So if anybody have any doubts, you can ask me through the live chat button, the live chat box. So guys, without wasting much time, let's go into unit conversions. Okay, we will start the actual syllabus tomorrow. Let us just try to complete the unit conversions. Okay. See guys, for understanding the unit conversions, means to do any type of unit conversions, you need to remember only six formulas or lines that I say. Okay, let's start one by one. The first one is the density conversion. Okay, hey guys, I forgot to tell you everything about this. See, before starting, I would like to say one thing. See, what we will be doing during the live classes is you will be taking notes, and you will be listening to the classes, and you can ask any doubt in the live chat box. You can stop me at any moment. Okay, so suppose let us think, tomorrow we are starting with reservoir engineering. Every particular student, I want you to have three notes. Okay, one is the class notes. This is the notes which you will be writing during the classes. Okay, all the things that I say during the class, you need to write in these particular notes. I will be giving you some time to write the notes also, so don't worry about that. So the first one is the class notes. The second one is the numerical notes. What do you mean by numerical notes? See, after completion of every topic, I will give you some assignment. Okay, see, before discussing the exercises in Abhijit Dandekar craft or Tarak Ahmad, I will give you some time to do it yourself. You need to able to do all those questions and write it in the numerical notes. And apart from these numericals in these three or any other books that you find, you need to accumulate all the numericals related to one particular topic in these particular notes. That is the numerical notes. Okay. The third one is the theoretical notes. What do you mean by that? Guys, this is very, very important. The third one is very, very important. See, if anybody has written the GATE 2020 or 2021 paper, majority of questions, that is from reservoir engineering, are directly from the books, that is the standard or different books, different standard books. So, see, basically after completion of the chapter or topic, I will be giving you some assignment to study a particular topic from that book. I will be also giving you the page numbers to study. You need to study all the theory in different books, and if you find any new topic or any new point in those particular book, you need to incorporate it in the theoretical notes. These are the three notes that I want you to have. Okay, the class notes, numerical notes, and theoretical notes. The theoretical notes is very, very important, because if you are able to go to several standard books throughout the 11 month period, if you encounter a question directly from that standard book in the GATE examination, you need to be able to directly answer it. That is the main purpose of the theoretical notes. And the main thing about the theoretical notes is you can revise it just before the GATE examination effectively. Okay, so let us start the class, guys. So first we will start with unit conversions. So try to take a very good notes. That is most important. Okay, some of the six formulas that you need to remember to convert anything. To convert anything. See, at the end, I will explain how these particular conversions are useful to you. Okay. So first, let us start with density conversion. Write it in your notes. So for this, you need to remember this particular formula, that is the line. 1 gram per cc. Cubic centimeter is equal to 8.33 ppg. This is pound mass per gallon. Guys, there is a slight difference between pound mass and pound force. What do you mean by pound mass and pound force? This is a unit of mass, kg, whereas pound force is, it is like Newton, that is LBF, that is the pound force, if, is equal to LBM, this is the pound mass into acceleration due to gravity. Yes, yes, yes. If it is possible, we will release this particular video in the YouTube also. So don't worry. Guys, write it down. This is most important. This is pound force. This is pound mass. Guys, if you remember 12th class. See, consider this is a body of 10 kg. Okay. This particular mass of the particular body is 10 kg. Whenever we ask weight of that particular body, we will say 10 kg into acceleration due to gravity, that is 10 into 9.81 kg meter per second square, which is Newton, that is 98.1 Newton is the weight of that particular body. Similarly, Consider this is 10 pounds. Whenever we are talking about mass, we use the abbreviation LBM, pound mass. The mass of that particular body will be 10 LBM, whereas the weight of that particular body into 10 LBM into G. That is equal to 10 LBF, because LBF is equal to LBM into G. Okay, this is very, very, very important, guys. The G, where G is equal to 32.2 feet per second square. We'll go one by one. You need to know the main difference between LBF and LBM. LBM means pound mass, which is related to mass of the body. LBF is a force, which is in synchronization to Newton. This is in synchronization to kg. Okay, know the difference. You will know the difference in the future classes, so don't worry about that. But you need to know the difference right now. Okay, if anybody has any doubt, you can ask me in the live chat. If you want me to repeat it, ask me, I will repeat it again. Do anybody have any doubt in the difference between the pound mass and pound force? Okay. Next, this is pound mass per feet cube, kg per meter cube. Next one is the kg per meter cube. I think everybody knows this. Okay. Let's go to the next one. Next is the volume conversion. Where, guys, write down this one. This is very important. This is the first one. This is the second one. Just by remembering these particular lines, you can convert any unit. Okay. So first write down this one. See, 1 barrel is equal to 42 gallons. And 1 barrel is equal to, this is gallons. And 1 barrel is equal to 5.6146 feet cube. which is equal to 0.16 meter cube. And from here you can convert it. 1 meter cube is equal to 1,000 liters. Okay. See guys, I think everybody knows this. 1 micrometer cube is equal to 10^-6 meter cube. I think everybody knows this. Okay. So write down this one. The volume conversions. If you want me to slow down, ask me in the chat box, guys. Or on the right hand side, you can see a raise hand button. Okay, it will directly communicate with me only. Okay. The next one is length conversion. This is meter. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter is equal to 3.28 feet. Okay, you can remember only this one, and 1 feet is equal to 12 inch. Leaving this. Okay, just write it, guys. Length conversions. I don't think I need to explain anything here. This is centimeter. Feet, inch. Okay. Let's go to the next one. The weight conversions. So guys, generally everybody knows 1 kg is equal to 1000 grams and 1 kg is equal to 2.2 pounds. Okay. And this, everybody knows this, but let's come here. 1 ton is equal to 1000 kgs. See, basically, there are two types of tons. One is UK ton, which we will be using, also known as TONNE. Next one is US ton, which generally is given as ton, TON ton. Basically, guys, in India, we will be following the British British conversion system. That is, 1 ton is equal to 1000 kgs. Okay, whereas, see, 1 ton is equal to 1000 kgs is equal to 2200 pounds. This is the US one, sorry, this is the UK one, which we will be following. Generally, whenever we say tons, TONs, we generally specify it as the British unit in India. You need to remember it. Okay. Only in USA, this US ton will be used. 1 ton is equal to, this is 2000 pounds. Okay. This is not used in India, guys. We will be using only the British units. 1 ton is equal to 1000 kgs is equal to 2200 pounds. Okay. And in any particular question, if you find ton in India, it means UK unit, not US. Remember, this is another one which majority of students usually does wrong. Okay. And don't worry, in GATE examination, they will specify the unit conversions. If there is any problem with the conversions, basically they will directly give the majority of conversions. Okay. In rare cases, they will not give it. Since they are not given unit conversions in 2019 and 2020 paper. But in some questions, they will give it. Okay. So this is the unit conversions for weight. Let's go to the next one. Pressure conversion. Guys, this is very important. 1 atmosphere is equal to 1.01 bar is equal to 14.7 PSI. What do you mean by PSI? This is pound force. Pound force per inch square. Pound force per inch square, that is PSI, not mass, it is a force. Pound force per inch square is PSI, Pascal. And last one is this, 760 MFG is the height of the mercury that it rises. Okay. So write it, guys. So this is the fifth conversion, pressure conversion. So write it carefully. 1 atmosphere is equal to 1 bar. Generally, we will take it 1 only, so don't worry. that is equal to 14.75 psi. PSI means pound force per inch square. Guys, you need to know the difference between pound mass and pound force. When you need to use the which one? Okay. Let's go to the next one, guys. Has everybody completed? The next one is the power conversion. 1 horsepower. ₹746 and 33,000 feet LBF per minute, which is equal to 2544 British thermal unit per hour. Guys, this is the unit that generally is used for separators, heat exchangers and all those things. BTU per hour, HP watt and feet LBF per minute is used for pumps, compressors and engines. Inside to combustion engines. This is generally used for separators, heat exchangers. Etc. Okay. Guys, you need to remember all these conversions mainly. The 6 conversions that I have given you. Density, weight, power, volume and weight. Okay. Guys, up to now, do anybody have any doubts regarding anything at all? These are conversions, the 6 conversions that you need to remember until the gate examination. So regularly use them in any conversion that you need to do. Okay. Next one is the miscellaneous conversions. Guys, there are some other units that you need to know. See, similar to Newton, Newton is nothing but force, which is equal to kg meter per second square, which is MKS units. Similarly for CGS units, dying is also a force. Instead of kg, it is gram. Instead of meter, it is centimeter. This is for MKS and this is for CGS. Guys, 1 newton is equal to dash dynes. Give your answer, guys. Try to convert it. Both are forces. One is in Newton, is in MKS for MKS units. Dyne is in CGS units. What I need you to do is convert 1 newton to dynes. 1 newton is equal to dash dynes. Give me your answer in the chat box, guys. Take your time. You need to be able to do it. (10⁵). Actually, it is correct. See, guys, 1 newton is equal to kg meter per second square. Wait a minute. 1 newton is equal to 1 kg meter per second square. We know that 1 kg is equal to 1000 grams. That is 10⁻³ grams. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. That is 10² cm per second square, which is 10⁵ gram centimeter per second square, which is 10⁵ dyne. Okay, in this particular way, you need to be able to convert the units. Okay. See, next is poise. Poise is a unit of viscosity, which generally majority of students find difficulty. See, generally viscosity, guys, viscosity. I think everybody knows this. As a Newtonian fluid, viscosity is given by stress divided by strain. Stress, the unit of stress is force. That can be Newton or Pascal or anything. Newton, let us consider in MKS units, Newton, and the strain is second inverse, Newton second. Okay, if you take that in CGS units, the unit of force will be dyne. Okay, sorry, Newton per meter square, sorry. Guys, stress units is Newton per meter square, that is the pressure unit. Okay, so these per, in CGS units, the stress will be dyne per centimeter square, whereas the unit of strain will be second inverse. So dyne per centimeter square into second is defined as poise. One poise is equal to 100 centipoise. So in this particular way, you can easily convert the units. Okay. Okay. Let me give a question, guys. Okay. Let's start. Let us do the exercise of the last. Let's go to the next conversion, the temperature conversions. I think we have studied it in the 12th class. So just write it. Celsius, Fahrenheit, Rankine, and Kelvin. So you need to remember this one also, guys. The temperature conversions. Rankine is equal to 400 plus 460. Both these units are different. This is R here. This is R. This is Reimers. You might have remembered it in 12th class. Rankine is different. Reimers is different. Okay. Actually, we will not be using this much. These three is more important. And with Rankine. Okay. So write it carefully, guys. Write it in our class notes. So let's go to the next one. So as I told you, there are several types of units. CGS, SI, that is also known as MKS, field units. Guys, so in different units, you need to remember for different things. Suppose our flow rate, in CGS it is CC per second. In SI it is meter cube per second. See, the main reason for remembering this is, see, in reservoir engineering and well testing, you need to remember the formulas for different units. For CGS units, I think everybody knows the Darcy's law will be same. Whereas for field units, a particular conversion factor will be given. Okay, so at that particular time, you need to remember the value of Q, the value of A, and their units. Okay, so at this starting only, we will assign for different units those particular ones. Suppose for flow rate, you need to remember these units. CC per second, length will be centimeter, pressure will be atmosphere, permeability will be Darcy, viscosity will be centipoise, area will be centimeter square. So you don't need to use the unit conversions in Darcy law. Whereas for SI unit, it will be slightly different. Instead of atmosphere, we will be using Pascal. And the same units will be used without any conversion factor. Okay. Similarly in well testing, you need to remember it for CGS and field units. So remembering units for each particular equation will be very difficult. So we are standardizing it. You will remember the unit conversions for CGS and fields differently. That's it. You don't have to remember the units. Okay. Then we have standardized the units for all the equations from now onwards. Okay. So try to remember the units. For flow rate is CGS is centimeter cube per second, meter cube per second in SI, field. Barrel per day for oil flow. For oil flow rate, we will discuss it as barrel per day. Whereas for flow rate of gas will be in feet cube per day. The other that we use is m feet cube per day. Okay. The other unit that you need to remember is m feet cube per day that we will use in drill testing. Okay, we will discuss this when the time comes. So for right now, write down the table, guys. Okay, has it been completed? See, let me give an example why the unit conversions are very, very important. Okay, 1 centipoise is equal to dash pascal second. Try to do this, guys. Try to do this. See, sometimes what happens is in the question they will give every unit in CGS except for the viscosity. Then you need to be able to convert the pascal second to centipoise. That's when these all the unit conversions that we have learned will be useful to us. So once try to do this, guys. 1 centipoise is equal to dash pascal second. Go from the basics. Go with the definition of poise. Centimeter square per second inverse, that is dyne second per centimeter square, one poise. Use this basic and try to convert it into pascal per second. Once try to do it, guys, this is very important. In the gate, a 2018 paper also, a question similar to this has been given, where you need to convert the centipoise to pascal second. So you need to be able to do it. Take your time and do it, guys. I think it is correct. See, simple. One poise is equal to 100 centipoise. I think everybody knows that. One newton per meter square is equal to dash dyne per centimeter square. That is 10 to the power 5. But we have already done it. 10 to the power 5 newton per meter square, which is in second. So 1 centipoise is equal to newton per meter square is nothing but pascal second. That is 10 to the power 3 pascal second. 1 centipoise is equal to 10 to the power 3 pascal second. It's a very simple conversion. All you need to do is you need to remember the basic definition of poise. Poise is defined under CGS units. Dyne per centimeter square per second inverse. Okay, do anybody have any doubts in this question? How to convert 1 centipoise to pascal second? Similarly, you need to be able to convert 1 centipoise to atmosphere second or atmosphere day based upon the units that we have given to you. Okay, that is the reason we are having an exam, guys, separate exam. In that particular examination, we will ask you questions similar to this. Okay, so let's go to the next one. Up to now, do anybody have any doubts at all? Any doubt at all regarding the unit conversions up to now? Okay, you need to remember the units of CGS, SI and field for different parameters. Flow rate, length, pressure, permeability, viscosity and area. Guys, 1 minute, I forgot something. Time also. Generally, it is second, and this is in hour. Yes. ओके। Let's go to the next one, guys. Some other term measures that you need to remember. So, this is 1 millidarcy is equal to 10 to the power minus 15 meter square, which we will derive in the permeability, but start remembering from now only. Okay, 1 millidarcy is equal to 10 to the power minus 15 meter square, which is an easy one. Then the gas constant 82.06 for CGS units. Whereas for fuel units, 10.73, this is most important, guys. 10.73 is the most important one. For CGS units, see, atmosphere, cubic centimeter, gram, mole, Kelvin, it is 82.06. So you don't have to remember these units because you know it is CGS. For CGS, it is 82.06. For fuel, it is 10.73. You know all the units. Okay, PV is equal to nRT, R is equal to 82.06, which is in CGS, so pressure will be atmosphere, volume will be centimeter cube, N will be mole, P will be in Kelvin, that is CGS units. For 10.73, which is field, pressure will be in PSI, volume will be in feet cube, temperature will be in Rankine. Okay, so you don't have to remember the unit, you just have to remember for field it 10.73 and CGS it is 82.06. Okay, don't worry guys, with number of questions that you do, you will automatically remember the R value. So don't worry right now. So just write it in your notes. And the lithology of the matrix density of sandstone, limestone and dolomite is also important. This is useful for calculation of porosity. It is also using in logging. Okay, sometimes you need to remember the matrix density of sandstone. It is this particular one is the most important one. 2.61. Okay, so try to remember the first one. With time you will remember the second and third one also, the limestone and dolomite. Okay, so let's go to the next one. Guys, am I going too fast? If anybody is having any problem in understanding the current scenario, you can ask me. Okay, I will repeat that particular one again. Okay, some other conversions. Just write it, guys. Just first write it. Okay, these particular conversions are mainly used in drilling. Up to now, these conversions are used in reservoir. These particular conversions are used in drilling. Okay, drilling engineering. Teeth zone pressure gradient 0.65, 0.465 psi per feet, which is nothing but the pressure gradient of salt water, pure salt water. Okay. Specific gravity of barite 4.2. Specific gravity of hematite is 5. What do you mean by specific gravity? Density of the substance divided by the density of water. Okay. One sack of cement will always weigh 94 pounds. One sack of barite or mud additives, any particular additives will weigh 100 pounds. Not only barite, any particular mud additives, one sack will weigh 100 pounds. Whereas cement will weigh 94 pounds. One quart is 946 ml, which is used in mud rheology experiments to find the viscosity. Okay, we will discuss it in drilling engineering. For now, try to remember it. Knots, guys, this particular knot is defined for a wing speed. Mainly these particular knots, knot is a term or a variable that is used to define the wind speed. Okay, that is 1.85 kilometer per hour or 1.15 miles per hour. Okay, so just write it, guys. The main reason you are writing all the unit conversions in one place is if you find any other additional other new variables or terms, you can write it in your notes. Okay, so first write it, we will discuss that one also. These are the conversions for drilling. Okay. Has it been completed, guys? Guys, give me your answer. Let's solve two to three exercises and we will stop the class. Okay. Convert the following measurements into milliliter. Take your own time, guys. Milliliter. Give me the first answer. What is the first answer? 0.75 liters is dash milliliter. -0.75 liters is equal to dash milliliter. Give your answer, guys. See, 1 Darcy is equal to 1000 millidarcy. Similarly, 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. Okay. So you need to just multiply it by 0.75. Okay. 0.75 liters is equal to 1000 into 0.75 milliliter. That is 750 milliliter. Okay. Similarly, here we have, this is microliter, that is 10 to the power minus 6. 1 liter is equal to, 1 microliter is equal to 10 to the power minus 6 liters. We need to just multiply 3.2 into 10 to the power 4 into milliliter is equal, microliter is equal to 3.2 into 10 to the power 4 into 10 to the power minus 6 liter. Okay, which is 3.2 into 10 to the power minus 2 liter. 1 liter is equal to 1000, that is 32 milliliter. Okay. Guys, do the last one yourself. It's an easy one. 1 meter cube is equal to 1000 liters. Guys, give me the answer for the last one. 500,000. Which I think it is correct only. Okay? You need to have, these are simple ones, guys. These are the simple conversions that you need to be able to do yourself. Okay, it is easy. Let us see the answers. 750, 32 milliliter, and 5 into 10 to the power 5 milliliter. That is correct. These are the ones that is very simple and you can do it using the conversions. Okay. Guys, give me this answer for this one. How many cubic feet are there in a room measuring 5 meter into 10 meter into 2? And guys, from tomorrow onwards, before, while attending the class, keep a calculator with you, okay, or a mobile which contains the calculator. Okay, see, we know that 1 meter is equal to 3.28 feet from the formula that I have given you. Okay, so this is 5 into 10 into 2 meter cube, that is 100 meter cube. 100 into 1 meter is 3.28 whole cube into feet cube. So this one will be the answer. 3.28 whole cube into 100 is the cubic feet answer. Okay. This is an easy one. 3,531.47. After we do it, see the main why did we study the unit conversions at the starting? How it is useful? You will understand it right now. Okay. See, consider this is a question. This particular question is given in 2016 or 2017 paper. Okay. I have given you the direct formula. Okay. You need to find the Reynolds number, guys. Try to do it yourself. Take some time, but try to do it yourself. Every particular value is given. The formula is given. What I am asking you is, give me the value of Reynolds number. You need to able to cancel out all the units because the Reynolds number is dimensionless. So the final answer must be a dimensionless answer. That means all the units must be cancelled out. Okay. See the question. You need to find the Reynolds number. The formula of Reynolds number is being given. Rho mu b L by mu. Okay. Diameter of the pipe is given 50 millimeter. Mm is millimeter. And the density of oil 920 kg per meter cube. The volumetric oil flow rate, that is 56 liter per minute. And the dynamic viscosity is given 40 millipascal second. This is millipascal second. So the end result must be, all the units must be cancelled. So you need to be able to convert some units, so it cancels out with the others. Guys, will you do it or shall I explain it? Take your time and once try this. Okay. The main reason that we have studied the unit conversions is so that you can able to do. See, the majority of students can remember the Reynolds number formula, but while applying the formula, the unit conversions is the difficult part for this particular question. Because you need to cancel out the units, which is very difficult while doing it. Once try it, guys. Write down the question. Write down the question properly. Write down the formula properly and try it. I will give you some time. Don't worry. The main reason that we are studying the unit conversions at the starting is, this is the reason. You need to be able to do these type of questions. Okay. Suppose we are doing a numerical on well testing. If all the units are different and not field units, you need to be able to convert all the units into field or all the units into CGS. Just by knowing the formula, you will not do the question correctly. You need to be able to convert the units also. That is the reason from the start only we are concentrating mainly on the units. So once try the question, guys. Guys, shall I start this question or is anybody trying it? See, the first test which will be on the unit conversions, questions similar to this with the formula and some other conversions will be given. Okay, so you need to be able to convert the units. Guys, take your mobile or calculators and try it. This is the most important point. The application part is the most important part. Just by knowing the formulas of the unit conversions is not enough. You need to be able to convert it and cancel the units. This is the final most difficult part of the unit conversions. Take your time. Guys, I think you don't know this. P is mu, U is equal to Q by A. Flow speed is given by flow rate by area. Okay. Flow rate is given. Area is pi by 4 d square. Guys, I will not do this question. Okay, I will be giving as a homework. Okay, we will discuss these question tomorrow morning, in tomorrow's class. The first thing tomorrow, we will discuss this question. In the meantime, try to do it yourself. Okay, and if anybody have completed the question with the answer, send it to me via WhatsApp. Okay, I will check it. Okay, if you are unable to do it, don't worry, we will discuss this question tomorrow. Okay, this is the most and important part of the unit conversions, the application part of the unit conversions. Okay, so we will discuss that this particular question tomorrow, guys. Has everybody written the question in your notes? Okay, we will discuss this question tomorrow. If any student has completed the question by yourself, send me the solution. Okay, I will check it. Remember this, Reynolds number is a dimensionless number. The final unit should be nil. The final answer should be nil. That is the units of the particular answer should be nil. That means all the units must get cancelled. So try to do it, guys. Okay, guys, up to now, do anybody have any other doubts? Up to now, do anybody have any other doubts? This is the most important part of the unit conversions. Write it in your notes. Okay, no doubts, guys, anybody? Okay. See, guys, today is Tuesday. The assignment for this is a unit conversion PDF will be given you in the group. Just try to solve all those questions. That will be sufficient. Okay, that is the assignment. It will be given to you tomorrow morning in the group that we have created. And the exam, as I told you, the first exam will be on unit conversions. Will be on Thursday. Okay, that means on Thursday we will have the live class paper discussion. Okay, that means Wednesday evening. Wednesday night, the paper will be released, guys. And by Thursday evening, by the time we have the class, you need to be able to complete the questions. We will have almost 15 questions. Okay, for 25 marks. Okay, time will be given us 35 minutes. Okay, on Thursday we will have the first exam, the unit conversions. Okay, tomorrow morning this particular unit conversions PDF will be given on the WhatsApp group. Try to solve those questions. Tomorrow we will start the actual syllabus. That we will start with the reservoir engineering, petrophysical properties of rock. Okay? Any doubts, guys? Up to now, do anybody have any other doubts? So, that's it, guys. The main reason for starting the class today haphazardly is, today actually is a very good day. That is the reason we have started the class today. So we will start the actual classes from tomorrow. This is also an important one, the unit conversions. As I told you, you need to have three notes. Okay. And the numericals that is given in the That is the numericals that is given in the unit conversion PDF that will be given in, write it in the numerical notes. Okay, it will help you. Any other doubts, guys? Any other doubts? Okay, then we'll stop the class today. Okay, we'll stop the class. That's it, guys. Bye. The group will be opened, and from tomorrow onwards, the class will start at 4:30 p.m. Do anybody have any problem with the timings, guys? 4:30 p.m. If anybody has any problem, we will shift it to 5 or 5:30. Okay. Okay, then that's it. From tomorrow onwards, the classes will start at 4:30 p.m. Okay. That's it, guys. Thank you for coming. Bye. Okay, guys. If anybody has any doubt, you can contact me through WhatsApp.